The young Princess Elizabeth first answered her call to duty at 16, where she inspected the guards at Windsor Castle. That day, she would become part of the fabric of the armed forces who would later pledge their allegiance to her. Having spent most of her teenage years in shelter during the war, her interest in the military grew as she watched her parents interact with the public in post-war Britain. In 1945, Princess Elizabeth, true to her nature of setting standards, became the first woman in the royal family to become a full-time member of the armed forces. She joined the Auxiliary Territorial Service as a motor driver and mechanic, inspiring many other women to do so. The then 18-year-old princess was to later become Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, with the military embedded in every aspect of her life. Throughout Her Majesty's reign, she supported Armed Forces personnel across the world and regularly visited her armed forces to show her support and gratitude for their service, meeting with servicemen and women, both at home and overseas. The Queen always acknowledged members of the armed services that had died in service to our country, paying tribute to them every year on Remembrance Sunday, Christmas, and more recently during the COVID pandemic. She also introduced the Elizabeth Cross Medal, which in the words of Her Majesty, gave further meaning to the nation's debt of gratitude to the families and loved ones of those who have died in the service of our country. The military has played important ceremonial roles in state visits, royal weddings, funerals, and of course, Trooping of the Colour parades for the Queen's official birthday. For many years, the Queen attended trooping on horseback dressed in military uniform. Queen Elizabeth was deeply involved with the military throughout her 96 years of life. This week, members of the armed forces across the UK and overseas pay their final respects to their head of the armed forces for 70 years, Queen Elizabeth II.